It's Monday and I'm excited because I think my sprinter is going to be ready at Walter's today. Excited to get it back. Been driving this big girl. My good friend Umberto Baca has multiple vehicles, so he was gracious enough to loan this to me while Walter's fixed my brain fart damage of putting gasoline in my sprinter. See how it says diesel? Apparently I wasn't reading.
Guys, we're here at the Swapmoto Live headquarters. Brought my bike in because we're gonna do a little maintenance. Gotta like find a stand to put it on. Wrong brand. It's pretty cool because it's the Kings, but what's that one? That one's like older than me. TWMX? Hell no. There we go. So the Factory Effects V1 bike stand is officially licensed by Kawasaki. There's Honda, Suzuki, and Yamaha versions available too. $89.95. It's made of lightweight steel. It's a little bit taller than those other stands over there, which makes it easy to get both wheels off the ground. And I don't know, man, the Cowie green stand just does it for me. So use the code SWAP25 to get 25% off a V1 bike stand of your own. FactoryEffects.com.
A little lunchtime field trip to see our boys at Husky and KTM. Chase needs a bolt to hold his chain guide on. And I need some handlebar mounts, apparently. Bro shows in there. It's the legend of motocross inside.
What's up, guys? How we doing?
Look at this guy.
Let's see the ring. Oh, you don't have your ring on.
I don't have one yet. Yeah.
Oh, yeah?
I'm taking her to the cleaner, though.
Let me ask you.
Have a nice one.
Did you cry?
No, I held it together,
oh,
dude.
Oh, you held it together?
No, I was good.
Nice.
I was good.
Whoa, it's a gassy kind of day in here.
Yeah, I'm seeing red now.
Huh?
Well, it's
good. Oh, 125.
Did you end up going to Polo?
Saturday, yeah.
Was it good?
It was all right. It got hot.
Perris is magical.
Is this the replica? Is this the factory edition?
No, just the 23s. We're throwing break-in plastic on them right now.
Oh. Bro show.
What's up?
You have the appropriate t-shirt on for the bikes that are out there.
Yep.
Huh?
Yep. Today I do it for once.
Mm. Why do gas look so cool? Just because of red.
Red, huh? Red is
blood red.
Yeah. Just like, you know, they love that red. I think they look really cool.
Yeah. It's a good red. It's better than Honda red.
Yeah. Yeah, especially now. I mean, this is, luckily they haven't changed the look too much. So
yeah.
It's pretty good.
So the 23 gas is the same chassis.
Yeah, that's it.
So that might be better for some people.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And it's cheaper,
mm-hmm.
You know, but you get the same products that we had previous that were
really
good.
So Dino's returning to action this weekend?
Mm-hmm.
Is Malcolm?
I think so. I was told that him and Malcolm were returning.
Malcolm doesn't want to.
No?
No, I thought he's all. Why I gotta return at Unadilla after 5 years of not racing outdoors?
Why is it that bad?
Well, it's the roughest,
I know,
gnarliest track.
Yeah, but dude, you see the stuff they ride in Florida? You've been there, right?
Dude, it's not Unadilla though.
Oh, I know. I'm sure.
But he said Alden said he's not ready.
Oh, really?
Yeah, up to speed wise.
Mm.
He said if Plessinger's getting like that 7th, 8th, no reason showing up to get 15.
Well, maybe he's not then. I don't know. I haven't seen anyone.
I just texted him to see.
Yeah, I asked. I saw Sean. I didn't ask him. Racing guy earlier
mm-hmm.
today. I wonder.
So I rode Perris Saturday.
Mm-hmm.
And my buddy sat on my bike and he's like, dude, your bars are all crooked. And I didn't even notice because I've been riding like that. But can I have a handlebar clamp piece?
Up on the new bike?
Yeah.
Really?
That goes in? I don't know. I didn't think it was bent, but Chase just said it was bent too.
Yeah, sure.
What are these?
Do you know
KTM helmets?
Yeah.
So we're at Perris here on Tuesday for a private ride day. My buddy Rich Young
rented out the track, invited me out, said I could bring a couple buddies. So I've got Scrub Daddy and Chase and Umberto with me. Riding green today because I finally got my green FXR kit. Wearing it with the McGrath helmet, which is bad luck at Glen Helen. Got Umberto and his skills gear. Pink. Gotta be a real man to wear pink. Let's see the back. Let's see the back. Do a spin. Woo! Skills racing.
Ready to roll.
Thank you, Ismail. I have a.
It's hilarious.
It's like Zombie Land, dude.
Oh, literally.
Alright, I have a job.
It's new kit day. Chase, Beto. Pink, orange, green.
Write them in the comments.
Pretty and pink.
Yeah.
Look at that.
Hey man, you know you shouldn't loop the chain that direction.
Why?
You should always turn forward.
It don't matter.
It does.
I've been doing this for 30 something years.
You know why you should?
Why?
Because if there was some dirt or something in there and you're spinning it backwards, it could knock your master link off.
Yeah, but it ain't never happened out of 30 years. See, don't jinx me now.
Just
30
saying.
30 years is a long time.
And what is that in your hand?
Come on,
I thought you brought the old bacon grease for the chain.
see how he be doing me? Come on, man, help me out.
guy sees me coming, pulls off. He's changed out of his gear, holding his camera before I even get back. What was up with that?
What, you cheated?
I wasn't cheating. Do you know how far I started behind you?
And I was watching you. I was like, okay, he's getting close. I was like, all right, we did like 10 laps.
Yeah, and then you're like, oh, I'll pull off.
Oh. Hey, I was done. I almost made a couple mistakes. I was like, I better stop.
I better stop before he gets the pass on camera.
Yeah, you was coming. I looked at him like, dang, he's making up time. I'm like, dang it. And I was trying to gas it like where I didn't think you was gassing it. But
hey, did you make that inside line right there?
Yep.
Hell yeah, dude. That was a good line. It was dry.
Yeah.
Dude, how slippery is the jump going into the rollers?
Woo.
I almost bought the farm a few times there.
Yeah, see, that's why I was like, okay, I'll stop.
Dang, that guy's sponsored by Red Bull.
Yeah.
See that? His shroud?
And he's number one. Look at, he's got the red background. He's the champ. He's the points leader.
Points leader in what country?
In America.
Mongolia? Mongoloid.
Oh.
Dude, it is hot.
It's hot. Real
it's hot. But you know what? I like the track like this rough. Except I don't know about the rough with water on it. Because it was slippery.
It's real slippery. Hey, now this is the track. This is good training.
Yeah. Throttle control. 350 would have been better. There's too much power in that for you.
Yeah.
Yeah, Tony. Oh. Well, he's suspension testing, see?
Oh, is that what he's doing?
That's what he's doing. He's testing the springs.
Oh, that's why he wanted to case it. Okay.
Yeah, he wants to case it.
Oh, on purpose.
There's Rob
is that
Healy.
Dancing out there?
Right. Yeah. Oh.
They're going to Joe Shimoda 30. Man, everybody's out here today.
Yeah. Those are the...
Look at Chase cutting the track just to come out here.
Oh yeah, here comes Chase.
He wants a photo. I'm going video on stage.
Here comes Chase.
Oh man.
Were you feeling like one of Cupine's victims out there?
Yeah.
You know, like this? Like, what do I do? What do I do? He got me! Reeling me in!
Yeah, hooked me in. Man, what is that? Your
titration.
What flavor is it?
Watermelon. It's watermelon. No, it ain't. Why is it yellow?
Because it's Arma.
Wait, is that
hey, he would love some
don't
of that.
You see the little pink right here? Wait, but is that from the King?
It's from the King. Yeah.
It's
the King.
Oh, I might have a little then. The King started water. The King request.
You'll like it. You may miss the seeds, but you'll like the juice.
You think he got some cane? You may hang around his guy too. God, he's gonna be playing. See? Get him, man! What is it?
It's crazy. Okay, so Chase and I busted Emter out of jail. Feel good to be out and about?
Dude, I needed to get out of the house bad. And I needed to give Sandra a break. She's going just as crazy as I am.
Yeah?
Turn right here.
Okay. So how are things progressing with the busted heels?
So I'm kind of in between doctor visits right now. I kind of had a 4-week span between when I go see Dr. Baum again. But 2 weeks I'll go see him, and hopefully it shows a bit of progress on the healing on the bones.
Yeah, is the one that's not operated on, did he say that the thing was starting to mend up?
It's been 3.5 weeks since I had an x-ray, so it was really hard to tell since then.
Yeah.
So the big test will be in a couple weeks.
Eating the bone up?
Yep. Bone up, vitamin D3, you name it, I'm taking it.
Does the bone up help the bone with Sandra?
No comment.
We're parked illegally at Bell HQ, right? Doesn't this seem kind of cheechy?
It smells like salt water.
Salt water?
Or Voss.
Voss? It's fucking Pinky's outline.
What?
Oh, push. How about that, huh? You could tell Benny chose this place. He's not here. There's a fucking helmet he wore on his show right there. man. Benny. Boxo, he got some toolboxes? It looks like somebody's trying to jimmy the door, huh? Now we're at Fox headquarters to have a meeting about the new Instinct 2 boot. My buddy Mark Finley's gonna run through the new features. He's like the world's best product guy. The rebirth of the Fox retail store.
It's coming back to life.
Huh?
Yeah, they were. It's been in progress.
Dude, sure. Nice designing. Oh, you got the bikes on display.
Yeah.
And the steering stem that doesn't turn on that one.
Dude, there's not one thing that turns on that bike. Like we, like Michael and all of us, we had to like carry it from Main Street out here and lift it in there. Last year, two years ago, we took it to the 125 Dream Race and we had to like all of us carry it outside into a van. And then, because the wheels don't roll, nothing on that bike works.
Yeah.
But eventually.
Well, it's because it was in the ocean.
Yeah, that was the one that was at the bottom of San Francisco Bay.
Yeah.
But eventually, like the plaques there, we have some rad little stories and photos around the bikes. And then up top, we have a replica of Palmer's 96 World Championships bike.
Mm.
And then we'll fill that out. We're just waiting on a couple more bikes. Nina Hoffman, who rides for Santa Cruz right now, had her first World Cup win this year. And we want to get her bike up there. And then we have a Stevie Smith bike that we're working on as well.
Nice.
One of his last Da Vinci's that he raced.
Dude. Okay, what's with the coveralls?
Oh, that's our, that is whatever you want to make of them. But we're doing a driveline now. It's Legion Drive product. And
like for UTVs?
For UTVs. Oh, so like the gloves have silicone gripper on the hands. The goggles are like thicker foam so you don't get sand and dust in them. And that's really a dust suit. So literally you can throw that on over the top of your clothes. Dust or mud. It's funny, side-by-sides are so regional, like the way people set them up. We're out here, we're pre-running, we want it full desert mode, but Florida and stuff, they're like running swamps and stuff in them.
Put super snorkels tall tire. On them?
Yes, snorkels. So our product guys kind of did a bunch of research to understand like what do people really look for. One of the cooler products here is actually this sun jersey. So this has like a little built-in balaclava. And it goes like halfway up instead of like full hood. It just goes halfway over your ears.
You sure it's not the COVID jersey?
That too. That's a good call, Don. So this literally under the helmet is like half instead of going all the way up. And as you guys know, like the dust in the side-by-sides is so crazy. The other thing with these is they're 50.
Oh, wait. So this is a side-by?
Yeah.
So the men get this baggy coverall and the women get yoga pants?
These are just leggings on that line, but great point. The men's styles, we have a ton of men's styles in these too, like camo prints and stuff. They've actually sold in and are selling really well for us.
Yeah.
So now our idea is if people are enjoying side-by-sides and they need product, we want to make sure we have the right product for them.
Yeah.
Like I said, the gloves, we have Legion Drive gloves. There's some that are like for cold weather. There's other ones that are just like a moto glove, but more silicone gripper on the palm for the steering wheel.
Wow.
Oh yeah, we have a set right here actually. We did some flannels, some tech flannels as well. But yeah, this is a good example of like what's going on the palm. This is the basic like drive glove. So not like, this isn't for cold weather. This is just literally to get people to have a glove that works for driving. We realized we were selling, or so many people were leaning on our product for side-by-side. We're like, hey, let's build some really specific product.
Are you the first moto company to start making?
I think some of the other brands have done some stuff, Don. That's a good question. But right here, what's cool here is this is really easy to snap into. And then there's that men's sun jersey. A big part of this jersey is like sun protection. So I think it's 50 SPF coverage. And again, full neck coverage, full front.
So that's
here.
Part of the jersey, that?
Yeah, it is. And you can just run it down. Like, we just did the Big Bear 200 a couple weeks ago. Didn't quite finish it, but 130 miles.
Yeah.
But we always run a neck gaiter because the sun just thrashes you. Uh-huh. So these are pretty cool where you can run it down and you can run it as a moto jersey and it works fine.
Nice.
Yeah. So goggles, gloves, jerseys. Again, the sun jerseys have kind of been the number one hit so far.
Mm-hmm.
Gloves and goggles have always been really strong for us. The other idea for us is to just get these in dealerships, like get some mannequins built like we have here to show people like...
Yeah, it's a conversation piece, right? People are like, what is that?
Yeah.
Like, just like I did, right?
Yep. And we use Carrie. Carrie's got a program going with... I forget which brand. It's either Razor or...
Oh, yeah, Polaris.
Polaris. He's with Polaris. So we felt like, hey, it's a perfect marriage. He's so one of our guys.
That's Carrie and that's Pink?
Yeah, exactly.
Huh? Yeah. Oh, I see you got the bootery on display on the wall.
Yeah, these aren't for sale yet in here.
Uh-huh.
And really, this store technically,
not
around the national is when we'll do like a hard launch. We're going to actually announce like official store opening. We'll be open 5 days a week at that point. And then in the back, dude, we like paved. We paved our pump track now. So the pump track is
really
sick, yeah. And then we expanded the mini moto track like for that event we did in January, the Backyard Invitational. Our dream eventually, you guys, is to have this as like an experience center. Like you could have the back open, people can come here, they can shop, they can go ride the pump track. That's long term. That's definitely what we're thinking. But right now, we just wanted to create a new retail experience. Like we wanted to create a space that's the highest level, like so our dealers could see this and understand like what's possible for them.
Yeah.
We've been building, we have a new fixture program that we've been putting into dealerships over the last year and a half. It's called Freestyle. We've installed more than 50 of those. We just installed one at Chaparral here in Southern California, Temecula Motorsports. So a lot of our bigger shops have taken on our fixture program now. And we've seen great sales increase because it just spreads it out and makes it way easier to shop. It really designates a Fox area and gives it like a Fox experience. And so this is just taking it to a whole nother level. This isn't necessarily the Freestyle fixtures. I'll show you guys Freestyle.
Yeah,
in the
but
back.
This is it's all gear. It's not casual.
There is lifestyle in here, actually.
Okay.
So you got lifestyle gear, Don.
Okay. Yeah.
So we'll have hats, tees, fleece, a little more of some training stuff we're working on. We're gonna have some more active product coming here soon. So we have an opportunity here to see how it looks in store and make adjustments of how it would show up in retail spaces before it goes live.
Hey, there's a hat Chase would want.
Look at that, Don.
Huh? Jet ski. We just picked up a jet ski from Cali.
I saw that.
Huh?
And Chase, looks like you've been right. You have your own, right?
I have five.
Yeah. I don't know if he's old enough to remember the good old days, PJS and
yeah, I don't know.
Butches, I've got some
butches. Yeah,
more of a looking up on Google Images than
But I think your ski kind of has a little bit of a retro look, right?
It looks like totally Slasher or PJS, Jacob's old.
Yeah, it's badass.
Yeah,
my brother used to grind cylinders for PJS.
No
like,
way.
Yeah, he used to grind cylinders back in the day for like Clem Research. Do you remember Clem?
Yeah,
Clem Research.
Yeah, in Riverside.
Yeah, so. And then we had a chance to showcase some heritage jerseys here.
Yeah.
Literally that top one over in the right. Jeff Fox, when he first got into moto, he was a manager at a motorcycle shop in Santa Clara, Grand Prix Motorcycles. And we had that jersey in our archives. I sent him a photo of it. I'm like, Jeff, is this the original? He's like, yep, that's one of the originals that we sold at the
shop. Dude, how about that Barnett jersey?
Barnett jersey is sick.
I remember it being blue and yellow, though, not black and yellow.
It's got a little bit of blue on the sleeves, Don. You can't quite see it from where you're at.
You know what's sad? When I see this one right here, the 1-800 Collect, you know what I thought of?
What?
The Terra Firma Ken remake.
You think the original.
Okay, hey, I guess. So that's...
That Carmichael is from Loretta Lynn's. Remember when he was from 93?
Yeah.
We were digging through our archives and he literally posted the week of Loretta's. It was a picture of him. And he's like, hey, he's like...
In that jersey.
Retro 93. I'm like, that's the fucking jersey.
That's so cool.
We got a good Stewart jersey there. Carmichael, when he used to wear orange on the Hondas all the time.
Yeah. Yeah, like so boring every race.
Totally.
That was the retirement, you all right?
Yep. No, it might be a little bit earlier. That's 04. He retired in 07, I think, was his last year.
And there's and a then Dungy jersey.
Where's Dungy from, this is Henry right here.
Henry,
from Honda.
The brown one. Yep. Actually, I wasn't a fan of that car.
The Henry is this one right here.
Oh, it
That's
is.
That's McGrath. The
brown
one. The brown one, yeah.
Okay.
And then, Dungy MXON, and then that's Ken Roxon from Colorado this year.
That one right there?
Yep.
Okay.
So it was kind of cool to go from like,
you guys need to quit making all these one-off kits that you're not selling. Dude.
Our sales guys feel the same way.
I keep seeing Kenny and stuff, and I'm all, dude.
Yeah.
Getting ready to text you, and they're all, that's
this
a one-off.
This past weekend was the kits they made for all the kits for Loretta's.
Yeah, stuff
is amazing.
So sweet.
It turned out so good, and it was just a cool... It looks so good at Loretta's. They're like, okay, we got to do it for the guys as well.
Yeah.
But yeah, believe me, our guys, the sales guys are always like, nah.
I know, cut it out.
That gear. So yeah, this is the new space.
Nice.
Yeah.
Good chase.
And we'll keep you guys.
What did I tell you? Fucking silver tongue, right?
Yeah.
Look, and the info just flows off his tongue.
Just flows.
On the way in, I was like, the world's best product presentation from Mark Finley.
That's so funny.
back for the second time since Benny was at the Philly cheesesteak place for lunch. I bet you that's where he walked. Will he be on a high-powered conference call with Europe, you think? Ah, there he is.
What's up?
Were we at the Philly cheesesteak place?
Yeah, I just was hanging out there.
That's where you walked to?
Oh, all of them.
We're all here. What can I not show? What do I have to pixel out today?
Huh? Just like that behind you.
That one right there?
Yeah, you can't
show this that one too.
That's pretty sick.
New too, yeah, I can't show that one.
Can't show that either. Sorry, guys.
Some stuff over there you can't see.
Who's the ball guy?
That's JC, another one of our marketing managers. Mm. He lives in Wisconsin. He's just in town to do a shoot with Street Helmet.
Oh.
Yeah.
So you were just living the 909 lifestyle yesterday?
Dude,
watching guys hit ramps?
That lifestyle is not for me.
Huh? Yeah, did you have the hives cleared up yet?
Yeah, huh? Just barely.
Oh, yeah. I told him, I go, hey, dude. You're in the 909. Orange County guy, like, you bust out in hives when you're there too much. And he's all, you're right. I'm kind of itchy.
Yeah, the clock is ticking.
So who are you shooting? Twitch, Wanky?
And Patrick Evans.
Patrick Evans can throw down for a non-freestyle guy, huh?
Did you see the clip where he had a flat tire?
Oh.
Yeah.
What did he shit?
I got a video of him, and he comes around, and he has a fully flat tire, and then he cranks a whip.
Anyway.
Yeah.
He don't care.
Yeah.
You don't care. So, what's new? Anything new that we can show?
No.
No?
That's, I mean...
Just that one. When does that one over there drop?
That one's January.
That one right there.
So, born for you.
That's
January?
Yeah.
It should have dropped last weekend.
I agree.
Big hint. Big hint.
I agree.
The Washougal drop. What is that? What is that helmet behind it, that open face?
That's probably something you wore on a three-wheeler.
Is it?
Yeah.
Let's see. I'm gonna try this out. Did you see that sick road helmet I got?
You know we made one like that?
With a slip-on visor?
Like with magnetic. Yeah, they just stole that with their friends. There's not much padding on the inside.
Why did it say Ford?
I don't know. This was just one that we found.
Oh, what? Someone hit their head in the back of it already.
Here, caught on fire or something.
Mm-hmm. So, are we still doing the Goodwill vlog giveaway? Yeah. So, thanks to Mr. Raphael here. Once a week, I get to give some lucky person a Moto 10.
And introduce that is in the vlog to JC.
JC.
Hi.
I'm Don.
Hey, JC, nice to meet you.
I'm sorry that you have to work with this guy.
Don's this piece of shit that we spend money with.
Hey, did you see him scratching his arms and neck this morning? Because he had to spend some hours in the Inland Empire yesterday. And
a
fancy Orange County guy like that breaks out in hives when he's too far from the ocean. Huh?
That doesn't surprise me.
Yeah, my socks got taller and my shorts got longer. And
your hat bill got flatter.
Just flattened out. The rake on my truck got all crazy.
I was disappointed not to see the Harley in the parking lot today.
Yeah, it's too hot.
Whoa. Now you're a fair weather bad biker dude? Dude,
I always was.
The leather cut.
Huh?
It gets too hot with that leather on.
Yeah.
Can't do that.
And then he gets the really bad arm tan because he rides around in a leather vest.
Yeah.
With no shirt.
Oh, I'll borrow your freaking sleeves that I know you have when you mountain bike.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That works.
Okay.
It works.
Don't tell me.
Evens it out. Did I tell you that story?
No.
I evened out my farmer's tan in Punta Cana.
Yeah.
The first day on the beach, I wore my mountain bike arm warmers.
Dude, I know.
Huh?
I
remember. It was excellent.
Yeah, I remember.
Yeah.
I remember.
So, what do you think, JC, of making a Bell Harley limited edition shirt for Benny that says, if you can read this, the bitch fell off?
Yeah, I'm down.
Huh? Did you see the Wolverine, heel like a Wolverine t-shirt that we made?
No, I didn't.
Good.
Huh? Does Kyle ever wear his?
Did you give Kyle one?
Kyle has one.
I will kill him. If he wore it, I would light it on fire.
Cooper Webb wears his. Dahmer wore his the other day in my vlog. He had it on.
He's a piece of shit too. I'm done with Dahmer.
Okay, what's in here?
Yeah, we got all kinds of stuff.
Oh, youths too.
Yeah, kid stuff, old stuff, just for you to go.
Okay, so I had MC sign my McGrath Moto 10.
Yeah.
He wrote, too slow time. I see you already crashed in this, better retire it. And so we
literally did.
We put it on the set of the SML show today.
Oh, good. Relic.
You know?
Alrighty.
Because someone else is late on their bill, so we replaced it with the bell.
Oh, no.
And, yeah. And then I called you and said, did you really get me one for Buds? And you forgot. You just dogged me up.
But we'll get you one.
Okay. Can you order one?
Yes.
Okay, because I still need to wear one. Did you see how good it looked yesterday?
It looked really good.
It looked on fire.
Yeah, you're repping that thing pretty good. We appreciate it.
It's really hard for you to say nice things, isn't it? Update shows. Do you remember the first time we interviewed you at Transworld for this race series and you gave like one word answers?
I think so. It's been a while, but I remember a little bit.
Yes. No. The chair's here somewhere, right? Where's your race this weekend? Idaho?
Idaho.
Did you know that Idaho is the only state that doesn't have a contestant in Miss Black USA?
I didn't know that.
Huh?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, no one wants to be Miss Idaho. I might have to take that out of the vlog.
I was drinking sweat and I was like, oh, I gotta go shower. It was late. Thought it was gonna be an hour and a half. But we made it.
Is it ankle? Foot?
Ankle. Dude. Yeah. I did. I put a good number on it somehow. And it's like quick how it happened. But.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's pretty good though, carrying your Starbucks with crutches.
Yeah, I gotta have my coffee.
Here, how don't you spill that? I'll give you a hand with it. I'll hide it here behind your chair.
Yeah, rocks will get mad at me.
Oh, yeah. Okay, we're here on a beautiful Thursday before Chase and I head to Alabama.
You cut a hole in your chair.
Snow summit. We got Rich Young here with us for the first time. You've never been to a bike park, you said.
Nope, not up here.
He says all his friends are soft. They won't come here with us, with him. So he had to find new friends to ride with.
Thank you.
Rich is a downhill aficionado now. Calling out the trails he wants to hit. So we're gonna track his progress. Party wave, oh, miracle mile. Yeah, no big deal. Yeah. Thank you.
one.
Oh, inside line. Here we go.
Shredder goes first. Blind? This is blind.
And then when we get to the caterpillar, it's on, baby.
Woo! So blind. dig so hard.
Oh, fuck. Wow. Dude, we got all the jumps.
Oh.
Can you take a breather? Sorry, Melissa. Chase cut his dick off. And this is where I die.
I think Chase's dick is bleeding.
Yeah, he said he cut it off. So I'm scared of this thing. Rachel does it and she says it's nothing. Dude, I shouldn't have looked at it. Are you doing it?
Oh my gosh, this is way gnarlier than the caterpillar.
Yeah. I guess the time to try it is when the patrol guy's here.
You did it!
Thank you.
So you can go.
Thanks
like
for the coach.
A little faster, but I didn't want to go too fast enough.
Whoa! Fast like that?
His balls next. Yeah, that was perfect. Now you know you can go a little.
You know what's so funny is anytime you get on something on your bike and your perspective is higher, it's less scary. Would say, come on Chase, get out of my way, but Chase is with me. Off the gas.
It's more of a Benny.
Is this Benny?
He loves road kings. Some drag pipes, bait bars.
He doesn't have numbers on the saddlebags though.
That's not Benny's though.
Oh, that's not? He told me those numbers stood for the number of bitches he slayed. Chase and I are on our way to Montgomery, Alabama.
Huh?
Montgomery, Alabama.
Montgomery. Home of the best Korean barbecue.
Yeah, that's true. We're headed to Mini Major East. 3 days of fun in the sun and humidity.
Man, I wish I had been better to my mother and my father. I don't want you to be in that.
The break.
What do you think of the Mini Major East?
It's awesome, man. It's got all the classes for the kids, so I'm not sending my beginner daughter out there with the fastest kids in the 7-day class, so that's nice for sure.
And how about this track?
It's amazing. My daughter's terrified of the hill, but it's awesome.
Dan,
what's up, Don?
How many motos do you have to dock the gate on today?
A lot. What did I see? 26 around, right? There's 26 motos.
Yeah.
And I'm in 8 of them.
Busy day.
Yeah. It's been a mellow morning, but now it's about to ramp. I think she's 12? We're 12, 15, 16, 18, 19. 26.
So last year was your first year here, right? First big race with the kids?
Yeah. So we're pretty much coming up 1 year anniversary. I think this race might be a little later than normal, but yeah, I think 1 year racing anniversary for the kids will come a long way.
Ready to go, bud?
Do you like this track?
Yeah, it's a really fun track. We were here last year, and it was really fun.
Yeah, so last year was your like first big race, right?
Yeah, right?
It's been quite a year for you.
Mm-hmm. Yep, but it's super fun. Pretty much the same. They changed a little bit on it, but it's really good. I like it.
How many classes are you racing?
I was racing 3, but I dropped it down to 2 because I was getting a little tired. Uh-huh. So,
nice.
Doing 2 races.
Good luck.
Thank you.
So how's it going?
So
you break the visor off yet?
Beginner and modified
it's going hot though.
It's hot. Not like California.
Not at all. It's not very hot, but then you're just sweating so much.
Did you like how it rained for 10 minutes and then got even hotter?
Yeah, it was pretty good. It actually helped the track.
Yeah, it helped the track.
Sounds delicious.
Didn't help my armpits though. Sweating.
Yeah.
So how's the track this year compared to last?
Last year? It was a lot more ruddy, it seemed like. This year, it's a lot of just small ruts, but a lot of small ruts everywhere.
Mm-hmm. You like the new jumps that they built?
Yeah, it's pretty fun.
Yeah. What's better, this or your favorite track in California?
Probably this. The dirt here is so awesome.
Filling these in was really smart.
How are you feeling about the mud?
Not too great, but I feel like we prepped pretty good.
You got the big
Yeah, we got the foam head. Spray my helmet, so.
You look like Scrub Daddy with that afro on. What'd you think about the rain and the mud and all that?
It was pretty muddy and fun.
Yeah? What do you like better, racing on the east or the west?
I like the east.
Yeah? What's better about the east coast?
Well, at the west coast, you don't really get to race in the mud that much.
Cool. Good job, bud. You're number one. All right, Moto Mom. 1 year ago, it started here, right?
It did, actually. It's kind of crazy that it's been a year already. But it's nice to see the progression, and you know, the kids rode the beginner class last year and now they're in the real class and you know, chipping away at it. They're having a really good time, and again, we didn't know what we were getting into or if they'd be that keen, but we're still here showing up, so it's a great event for them. And yeah, just it's nice to see the progress, you know, and just see what they've learned in a year.
Yeah. What's this race like for you compared to the other big ones, because there's no big bikes, it's all little bikes?
Yeah, I mean, it kind of like, I guess it goes through a lot quicker, and there's the option to have, you know, a few different classes that you maybe wouldn't pick, you know, in other at other events. But yeah, the kids really like it, and it's obviously focused on, you know, again, we have a race, you guys have, like, more races the better, you know, so I think it's really good, and that's why we're trying to show up and support as many races as we can, because that's what the sport needs and that's what kids need to get better. So I think it's really important that they have these kind of events, and yeah, the more the merrier for sure.
Okay, last question. On a personal note, what's more stressful, Moto Wife or Moto Mom?
Moto Wife. Moto Mom is good. I'm good so far. Now, ask me that again in a couple of years when things start to get a lot more heated, then we might change. So we'll see. That could be an evolving thing. But yeah, I mean, when you're at the top of the top pro level and everything's on the line, I mean, that is way more stressful. And not from like a, ooh, what's gonna happen? It's just like competitive, you know? So Chad's always on me of how, you know, intense I was with him, and I'm so easy on the kids. I'm like, they're a year in. I'm like, they're still deciding if that's their thing or not, or just having fun with it. So anyway, if we keep going this way, you keep asking me, okay?
Yeah. You know, it's really cute. I saw Case and Kia.
Kaya
come back. Uh-huh. And he had another race or something. And
oh my God.
She was so mothering, like helping
She's
him clean
so
his
good.
Goggles and everything.
She's so, so helpful. And especially, that's probably the hardest thing, is the back-to-back motos, especially on a mudder. Chad's like cleaning. We're trying to like get kids back and forth on the line. So it's really intense. Like, I mean, literally you're sweating, you know, just trying to get that done. So she's so good helping out, like, so that we can watch Tate on the track, or, you know, she'll come back and fix him up and get him on his other bike. And she's awesome.
She had his goggles and she was wiping his helmet. Wipe your face, you have mud on your face.
Oh my gosh, she's so sweet and so reliable. Like, I could just tell her to handle it and she's got it, you know? So for a 10-year-old, she's killing the game.
Well, hey, thank you guys for supporting the mini-majors.
Hey, thanks for having us.